Hi everyone, a warm welcome to the fourth part of line integral.
Complex definite integrals are called line integrals. They are denoted by integral over c f of z dz. Here the integrand f z is integrated over a curve c or through a portion of c. Really these integrals are complex integrals in terms of real definite integrals. So we can evaluate these types of integrals by converting into real definite integrals. In our problem, c may be straight lines, triangle, square, rectangle, parabola, or a part of a parabola, circle, or a portion of a circle. Also, at times, c is given by its parameter representations.
In this video, I include few evaluation along c in which its parameter representation is given. Let me start. Let me evaluate a very interesting question. Integral over c raised to z dz, where c is the shortest path from pi by 2i to pi i. So here we have to evaluate e raised to z along the curve c. The curve c is given as the shortest path from pi by 2i to pi i. First you mark the points pi by 2i. What is pi by 2i? See, pi by 2i is the point ordered by 0, pi by 2. Pi I is the point 0, pi. Pi is 3.14. So it is, suppose it is 1. So here, this is the point I pi by 2. And it is 0, pi by 2. Next, 0, pi. 0, pi is here. So this is the point ordered pair 0, pi. So this is the point I pi. As in the straight line is AB. So we have to evaluate along AB. So integral over c e raised to z dz is integral along AB e raised to x plus iy. What is dz? It is dx plus I dy. See, what is AB? Equation of AB is, see, on AB you can see x is 0. So equation of AB is x equal to 0. So what is dx? It is also 0. So this integral becomes integral. You put x equal to 0. So e raised to iy into I dy. You put the limit for y. Along AB, y varies from pi by 2 to pi. Really, for evaluating such integrals, we have to convert into a single variable. Then you integrate with respect to that variable. For converting, you consider the path along which we have to integrate. So based on the equation of the path, we can easily convert into an integral which contains a single variable. Now it is reduced into the form of a single variable and its limits is given. So by real integration, we will get the answer of the complex integral. Here, I is a constant. What is integral e raised to iy? We know integral e raised to ax is e raised to ax by a. So its integral is e raised to iy by I. From pi by 2 to pi, I cancel each other and it is e raised to iy from pi by 2 to pi. It is e raised to iy minus e raised to I, pi by 2. You can give the answer as e raised to I pi minus e raised to I pi by 2. Or you can give the value of these two terms. What is e raised to I pi? See, we know e raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. So what is e raised to I pi? It is cos pi plus I sin pi. What is cos pi? It is minus 1. Plus what is sin pi? It is 0. So it is minus 1. So minus 1 minus. What is e raised to I pi by 2? It is cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2. See, cos pi by 2 is 0. Sin pi by 2 is 1. So you can see it is I. So the answer is minus. Next, we have to evaluate integral over c raised to dz, where c is the parabola of y equal to 1 plus half into x minus 1 the whole square from 1 plus I to 3 plus 3i. See, here we have to integrate real part of z along a part of the parabola, which is y equal to 1 plus half into x minus 1 the whole square from 1 plus i to 3 plus 3i. 1 plus i is the point, 1 and 3 plus 3 is the point 3 3. See, we have to evaluate this integral from 1 to 3 3. Along the parabola y equal to 1 plus half into x minus 1 by whole square. See, integral over c real is a dz is integral over c. What is real part of z? It is x. What is dz? It is dx plus I dy. See, really you can evaluate this integral if you convert this integral in terms of a single variable. Then by applying real integration, real is, it will convert into a real definite integral. Then you evaluate that real definite integral, we can evaluate the given complex integral. For converting into the single variable, we have to consider the path of integration. Here, c is, on c, c is a part of the parabola. On c, what is y? Y is 1 plus half into x minus 1 the whole square. So what is dy? Dy is 2 into 1 by 2 into x minus 1 dx. That is dy is x minus 1 dx. So this integral becomes integral over. Here y is this one. So x into dx plus. What is dy? Dy is x minus 1 into dx. Now it is completely in terms of x. You put the limit for x. See, we have to integrate from 1 to 3, 3. So x varies from 1 to 3. So you put the limit for x. It is 1, 3. So for evaluating this complex integral, you have to evaluate this definite integral. And it is, you take dx outside, you can see it is x into 1 plus ix minus I into dx. You take dx outside, so 1 plus ix minus I. Integral 1 to 3. For the convenience of integration, you open the bracket x plus ix square minus I into x dx. And its integral is x squared by 2 plus ix cubed by 3 minus ix squared by 2 from 1 to 3. You put the limits 3 squared 9 by 2 plus 27 I by 3 minus I 9 by 2 minus lower limit 1 by 2 plus I by 3 minus I by 2. Next you simplify. See, it is 9 by 2 plus, you can remove by 3, it is 9 I minus 9 I by 2 minus half minus I by 2 plus I by 2. See, this is the answer, you simplify. Here we can take, see, it is minus half minus I by 3. See, this is, by combining these two, you can see it is 9 by 2. Then you take this real number to this real number, minus half plus, it is 9 I by 2 minus I by 3 plus I by 2. Let me simplify the real part and imaginary part. So it is, the real part is, what is its real part? You take 2 LCM, you can see it is 8 by 2. 8 by 2 plus, here you take 6 LCM. So 27i minus 2i plus 3i. So it is 4 plus 28i by 6. That is 4 plus 14i by 3. Next we have to evaluate integral 0 to 4 plus 2i. It's a continued dz along the curve given by z equal to t squared plus it. See, the representation of the curve is entirely different from all the previous questions. That's the difference in this question. But it is very easy for evaluating. See, the curve is given as z equal to t squared plus it. Really, it is the parameter representation of the curve. See, always z is x plus iy. So, what is x? See, z equal to x plus iy. So, what is the parameter representation of the curve? X equal to t squared and y equal to t. See, this is the parameter representation of the given curve. See, here we have to evaluate integral 0 to 4 plus 2y set conjugate integral. What is the set conjugate? It is x minus iy. What is dz? It is dx plus I dy. We have to evaluate from 0 to 4 plus 2y. 0 is the point 0, 0. 4 plus 2y is the point 4. Really, for evaluating this integral, we have to convert the integrand into a single variable. That's our aim. Here the curve is given in its parameter representation, and its parameter representation is x equal to t square and y equal to t. So you put x equal to t square and y equal to t, then you can see it is completely in terms of t. Here it is integral. What is x of t square minus I into what is y? It is t. What is dx? Dx is 2t dt. What is dy? It is dt. So 2t dt plus I into dt. See, now the integrand is completely in terms of a single variable, which is t. So you have to put the limit for t. What is the limit for t? Really, the limit for t is not given, but we can find the limits for t. Here, y is t. What is the variation of y? Y varies from 0 to 2. Y varies from 0 to 2. When y equal to t, what is t? Sorry, y equal to 0. When y is 0, what is t? T equal to 0. When y is equal to 2, what is t? T is equal to 2. So, when y varies from 0 to 2, t, t varies from 0 to 2. So, the limit for t is 0 to 2. Or you can also find the limit for t by considering the limit for x. What are same? See, this is the shortest way for finding the limit for t, because y is equal to t. If you consider x equal to t square, see clearly the limit for t, x is 0 to 4. X varies from 0 to 4. So t varies from, when x is 0, what is t? It is 0. When x is 4, what is t? T square is 4. So t is equal to plus or minus 2. Here you take the positive value. T again is equal to 2. So next we have to integrate this integral. That is integral t equal to 0 to 2. For the convenience of integration, you take dt outside. So t square minus I t into 2t plus I into dt. It is integral 0 to 2. You open the bracket. 2t cube plus I t square minus I 2 t square plus t into dt. It is t raised to 4 by 2 plus I t cube by 3 minus I 2 t cube by 3 plus t square by 2 from 0 to 2. It is 2 raised to 4 by 2 plus I 2 cube by 3 minus I 2 t cube by 3 plus 2 square by 2, and the lower limit is completely 0. So here it is 8 plus 8 I by 3 minus 2 raised to 4, it is 16 I by 3 plus 2. You see, this is the answer. Next, you simplify your own way. I combine the real terms and imaginary terms. So 10 plus, you here you take 3 LCM, 8i minus 16i, that is 10 plus minus 8i by 3. So the answer is 10 minus 8i by 3. Let me evaluate one more integral. It is integral over C, set conjugate dz, where C is given by the curve x equal to 3t, y equal to t square, and also given minus 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 4. Here also, the curve is given in parameter representation, that is x equal to 3t and y equal to t square. So that is dx 3dt, that is dy 2t dt. Also, the variation of t is given as minus 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to. Here we have to integrate. It's the conjugate dz along c. It is, this is a conjugate. It is x minus I y dx plus I dy over c. See, on c, what is x? It is 3t. What is y? It is t square. What is dx? 3dt. What is dy? It is 2t. See, now the integral is completely in terms of a single variable, so we can easily evaluate this complex integral. So if you have to put the limit for t, t is given as, t varies from minus 1 to 4. Really, we are evaluating this integral on the part of the given curve, it is from minus 1 to 4. Next, for the convenience of integration, here you take dt common outside, so 3t minus it square into 3 plus 2it dt. Next you open the bracket. It is integral minus 1 to 4, 9t plus 6it square minus 3it square plus I into ii square is minus 1, so plus 2t cube dt. Am I right? 9t plus 6it square minus 3it square plus 2t cube is right. Here we can combine these two terms. So integral minus 1 to 4, 9t plus 3it square plus 2t cube. Dt. That is its integral 9t square by 2 plus it cube plus t raised to 4 by 2 from minus 1 to. Next we have to put the upper limit and lower limit. When t is 4, 9 into 4 square by 2 plus I 4 cube plus 4 raised to 4 by 2 minus lower limit 9 by 2 minus I plus 1 by 2. That is 9 into, cancel 2 here. You can see this 8 plus 64i plus 128 minus 9 by 2 plus I minus R. That is equal to 72 plus 64i plus 128 minus 9 by 2 minus half. It is minus 10 by 2 plus I. That is, these together 200, right? Yes. Plus 65i minus 5, that is 195 plus 65i. Next, how to evaluate integral over c. Imaginary is the dz, where x equal to sine theta, y equal to cos theta, where theta lies between 0 and 2 pi. Here, we have to evaluate integral imaginary z, that is imaginary part of z, L of c. That is imaginary part of z, it is y. That is dz, it is dx plus dy. We have to evaluate L of c. See, here the difficulty is, we have a single integral with respect to two variables. It's not possible to evaluate. So you can easily evaluate if you convert into a single variable. See here, c is described as x equal to sine theta, y equal to cos theta. See, on c, x is sine theta, y is cos theta. Really, it is the parameter representation of the given curve. So on c, we have x equal to sine theta and y equal to cos theta. So you put these in this equation. So y cos theta, that is dx. Here dx is cos theta d theta. Similarly, dy is minus sin theta d theta. So cos theta into cos theta d theta plus minus I sin theta d theta. See, this is completely negative. Here integration is with respect to theta, so you put the limit for theta, it is from 0 to 1. Here you take d theta common outside. So cos square theta minus I sin theta cos theta into d theta. Next we have to integrate it. This is integral 0 to 2 pi. For integrating cos square theta, we have to write cos square theta as 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2 minus I into, what is sin theta cos theta? It is sin 2 theta by 2. That is integral 0 to 2 pi 1 by 2 plus cos 2 theta by 2 minus I sin 2 theta by 2 d theta. Its integral is integral half is theta by 2 plus sin 2 theta by 4 minus plus I cos 2 theta by 4 from 0 to 2 pi. You put the upper limit. 2 pi by 2 plus, that is sin 4 pi, it is 0. Cos 4 pi, it is 1. Minus 0 plus 0 plus I by 4. That is equal to pi plus I by 4 minus I by 4. So the answer is pi.